But the question of justice has concerned me greatly of late. And I say to any creature who may be listening, there can be no justice so long as laws are absolute. Even life itself is an exercise in exceptions.
You say you are true evil. Shall I tell you what true evil is? It is to submit to you. It is when we surrender our freedom, our dignity, instead of defying you.
Would you choose one life over 1,000, sir?
I refuse to let arithmetic decide questions like that. You have extended your life at the expense of another. Graves, give Data back. Give him back.
Data is dead.
No. He must not be lost. He's not simply an android. He's a life form, entirely unique.
Data is not human. He is
different. Yes. But that does not make him expendable or any less significant. No being is so important that he can usurp the rights of another.
We two are machines, just machines of a different type. Children are created from the building blocks of their parents' DNA. Are they property? Prove to the court that I am sentient.
This is absurd. We all know you're sentient.
So I'm sentient, but Commander Data is not.
That's right.
Uh-huh. Why? Why am I sentient?
Why am I self-aware?
Isn't that becoming a race?
And won't we be judged by how we treat that race? Now tell me, Commander, what is Data?
I don't understand.
What is he?
A machine.
Is he? Are you sure?
Yes.
You see, he's met two of your three criteria for sentience, so what if he meets the third? Consciousness, in even the smallest degree. What is he then? I don't know. Do you?
The decision you reach here today will determine how we will regard this creation of our genius. It will reveal the kind of a people we are, what he is destined to be. It will reach far beyond this courtroom and this one android. It could significantly redefine the boundaries of personal liberty and freedom, expanding them for some, savagely curtailing them for others. Are you prepared to condemn him and all who come after him to servitude and slavery? Your Honor, Starfleet was founded to seek out new life. Well, there it sits.
Then I regret that I must order you to transport Lal aboard my ship.
Belay that order, Mr. Data.
I beg your pardon.
I will take this to Starfleet myself.
I am Starfleet, Captain. Proceed, Commander.
Hold your ground, Mr. Data.
Captain, you are jeopardizing your command and your career.
There are times, sir, when men of good conscience cannot blindly follow orders. You acknowledge their sentience, but you ignore their personal liberties and freedom. Order a man to hand his child over to the state. Not while I'm his captain.
Your whisper from the dark has now become a plea. Cannot turn our backs.
We're out here to explore, to make contact with other life forms, to establish peaceful relations, but not to interfere. And absolutely not to destroy.
Dr. Stubbs, I cannot exterminate something that may or may not be intelligent.
We are also explorers. We mean no harm to any other living creature.
History has shown us that strength may be useless when faced with terrorism. I have never subscribed to the theory that political power flows from the battle of a gun.
Your report describes how rational these people are. Millennia ago, They abandoned their belief in the supernatural. Now you are asking me to sabotage that achievement, to send them back into the dark ages of superstition and ignorance and fear? No!
Please, get up. Get up. You must not kneel to me.
You do not wish it?
I do not deserve it.
Matter of internal security. The age-old cry of the oppressor.
People are scared. Don't you understand, Captain? They're dangerous.
You are dangerous. They're only victims. You made them what they are. You asked them to defend your way of life, and then you discarded them.
They're your brothers, your sons, and you turned your backs on them. And you have a decision to make, whether to try and force them back or welcome them home.
I have disobeyed a direct order from a superior officer. Although the result of my actions proved positive, the ends cannot justify the means.
No, they can't. However, the claim I was only following orders has been used to justify too many tragedies in our history. Starfleet doesn't want officers who will blindly follow orders without analyzing the situation.
Surrender. Consider the men and women you would lead into a lost cause.
If the cause is just and honorable, they are prepared to give their lives.
Your culture will adapt to service ours.
Impossible! My culture is based on freedom and self-determination.
You must comply.
We would rather die.
I think when one has been angry for a very long time, one gets used to it. Then it becomes comfortable, like old leather. And finally, become so familiar that one can't ever remember feeling any other way.
We're not hunters, Doctor, nor is it our role to exact revenge. Doctor, the sperm whale on Earth devours millions of cuttlefish as it roams the oceans. It is not evil, it is feeding. They've given away their humanity with this genetic manipulation. Many of the qualities that they breed out, the uncertainty, self-discovery, the unknown. These are many of the qualities that make life worth living.
Well, at least to me. I wouldn't want to live my life knowing that my future was written, that my boundaries had been already set.
A person's life, their future, hinges on each of a thousand choices. Living is making choices.
Sometimes the moral obligations of command are less than clear. I have to weigh the good of the many against the needs of the individual and try to balance them.
He refused to answer the question about his Romulan grandfather.
That is not a crime, Worf. Nor can we infer his guilt because he didn't respond.
Sir, if a man were not afraid of the truth, he would answer.
Oh, no. We cannot allow ourselves to think that. The seventh guarantee is one of the most important rights granted by the Federation. We cannot take a fundamental principle of the Constitution and turn it against a citizen.
Sir, the Federation does have enemies. We must seek them out.
Oh, yes. That's how it starts. But the road from legitimate suspicion to rampant paranoia is very much shorter than we think.
Something is wrong here, Mr. Worf. I don't like what we have become.
He admits his mistake in falsifying his application, but that does not make him a traitor. What you're doing here is unethical. It's immoral. I'll fight it. Have we become so fearful? Have we become so cowardly that we must extinguish a man because he carries the blood of a current enemy? Admiral, let us not condemn Simon Tarsis or anyone else because of their bloodlines, or investigate others for their innocent associations. With the first link the chain is forged, the first speech. speech censured, the first thought forbidden, the first freedom denied, chains us all irrevocably. Villains who twirl their mustaches are easy to spot. Those who clothe themselves in good deeds are well camouflaged. But she, or someone like her, will always be with us, waiting for the right climate in which to flourish, spreading fear in the name of righteousness.
I feel as though I've been handed a weapon, sent into a room, and told to shoot a stranger. Well, I need some moral context to justify that action. And I don't have it. We must attack!
I do not fire on defenseless people. You cannot put a price on a life.
To use him in this manner, we'd be no better than the enemy that we seek to destroy.
But there are times when the greater good demands that certain sacrifices are made.
You cannot explain away a wantonly immoral act because you think that it is connected to some higher purpose.
Deanna Troi is just one individual.
That does not justify brutalizing her, nor any of the others you have used. Do you think that makes you appear courageous? Because you're mistaken. You're a coward, Alka. You exploit the innocent.
I don't think that I could sanction it. Please understand, Professor, that you are, in essence, a new life form. One that we didn't intend to create and that we don't fully understand. Now, the moral and ethical implications of deliberately creating another one like you are overwhelming.
Admiral, centuries ago, these North American Indians were forcibly displaced from their ancestral lands. These settlers on Dorvan 5 originally left Earth more than 200 years ago in order to preserve their cultural identity.
I am aware of that, Captain.
You see, Admiral, there are some very disturbing historical parallels here. Once more, they are being asked to leave their homes because of a political decision that has been taken by a distant government.
The Indians on Dorvan are a nomadic group that have settled there only 20 years ago, and at that time, they were warned that the planet was hotly disputed by the Cardassians. The bottom line is, they never should have gone there in the first place.
Granted. But to go to them now, after 20 years, and ask them to leave what is now their home.
To expose a child to this, to someone who is suffering, to see that it is you that inflict that suffering.
From the time Jor-Aura could crawl, she's been taught about the enemies of the Cardassians, and that enemies deserve their fate.
When children learn to devalue others, they can devalue anyone, including their parents. I know that once you were a peaceful people with a rich spiritual life.
What did peace and spirituality get us? People starved by the millions.
Since the military took over, hundreds of thousands more have died.
But we are feeding the people.
A belly may be full, but a spirit will be empty.
Must be rewarding to you to repay others for all those years of misery.
What do you mean?
Torture has never been a reliable means of extracting information. It is ultimately self-defeating as a means of control. One wonders that it's still practiced.
Whenever I look at you now, I won't see a powerful Cardassian warrior, I will see a six-year-old boy who is powerless to protect himself.
Be quiet!
In spite of all you've done to me, I find you a pitiable man.
The first duty of every Starfleet officer is to the truth, whether it's scientific truth, or historical truth, or personal truth. It is the guiding principle on which Starfleet is based.
Our puny behavior shows you a glimmer of the one thing that evades your omnipotence. A moral center. And if so, I can think of no crueler irony than that you should destroy this young woman whose only crime is that she's too human.
Jean-Luc, sometimes I think the only reason I come here is to listen to these wonderful speeches of yours.
There was a teacher of mine at the academy who had been confined to a wheelchair from birth. She was
Captain, spare me the inspirational anecdote.